this is Jerry. Today, we are going to create a Microsoft Word document, and we're going to insert some images in it. The first thing we want to do is make sure that the images are correct. I'm using Picasa. Picasa is a free program by Google. You can look it up and download it. We've got one image here that's already been cropped and it's nice and neat, and I've got two other images that I want to show you what we can do with them. The first one is the bottom end of a radio tower, and I only want to show the base. So what I can do is click on Crop. I can select, let's say, square, and then I can take this square and resize it and bring it to only what I want to show and tell it apply. And you see now it's got a nice view of the base where we're going to show these wires are twisted up here. Then what I can do is, it's got a button called I'm Feeling Lucky. I can click on it and you notice it made the image a lot clearer. Now go to File, Save, and the image has been saved. And we've got the new image all cropped. Now, say you didn't want to destroy your original image. We can go to something like this, and let's say I want to crop it. And instead of square, I want to do a manual crop. So I can take these and bring these down to however I want. Let's say I only wanted to show the cables where they penetrate. So I wanted to do something narrow like this. I can tell it apply. Then what I can do is go File, Save As, and call it something different, like Penetration. Okay, now hit Undo Crop. The original image is back the way it was, and you'll notice the new image has been added. And then we can go into the new image and we can darken it up and do whatever we want to do with it. So we've got our images, we're now done with Picasa. Okay, the next step is we're going to go into Microsoft Word. And this is where the fun starts. Word is it's a good program, but it's a flaky program and it will drive you buggy. We're going to want to throw some text and some images in there. We've just done the images. As far as the text goes, I don't feel like writing a whole lot of text, so I'm going to use Lorem Ipsum. Some typesetter back in the 1500s arranged a bunch of type and just made some random words, and he used that as part of his sales pitch, and people have been using it ever since. So anyway, radio report, and then we'll throw in several paragraphs of Lorem Ipsum here. All right, so we've got some text in here, and now we can do some stuff with it. So I'll select it all. I like to do a justified. See how it looks a lot nicer. You can change the spacing between the words. I like to use 1.15. It gives it a little bit of space without being, you know, too much. We'll set it for Arial 12 because I use that quite a bit. And so now you see we have some nice, neat, structured text. The title isn't really doing anything for me, so I'm going to go over here and select Title. And you see that makes it look a lot nicer. But because we're using Arial down here, I want to have some consistency. There we go. So now we've got a document. Looks great. I'm going to go File, Save As, and I'm going to put it where I'm doing this little video here, which is under my digital camera. And you see I've done a few videos using Microsoft Word, and we'll call it Radio Report. Okay, it's been saved. Now we can start putting in different things. You're going to see me save a file quite a bit, and there's a reason for that, and you'll probably see it at some point while we're doing this. Anyway, we've got a report, and in the top of the report I'd like to have some kind of an image. So I'm going to go Insert, Picture, and I'm going to go to where my images are. Again, use details, it's easier to find it that way. Ah, there we go, digital camera. Scroll through my videos to where I'm at, and now it's usually good to switch to thumbnails. So we're going to show, let's say, this image here first. Now actually, you know, I just want to do this one. There we go. So there's a nice image. It spans the entire width. Word will do that automatically, and for this one I like it. So I'm going to hit Picture Border. I'm going to throw a nice 1.5 point black around there, and I'm going to leave it alone. Looks good. I'm happy with it. Okay? So, we come down into our document a ways, and we want to show something else. We want to show the top of the radio tower. So, I can come in here, insert, picture, click on the top of the radio tower, and now you've got this huge image. It's so big it knocks the text out, and it's not really what we want. So, you can come up to here, and you see how it has a width and a height, and you can tell it just how big you want it. I want this thing to be 3 inches. Boom. Instantly, it's been resized. So here it is. It's sitting in there. I like this black border. I don't feel like going through the menu to set it again. So one of the things I can do is select the image, hit Format Painter, and then click on this image one time. And you notice it's got the format applied to it. On this one, I want a caption. So I'm going to go underneath it here and go Top of Tower. All right. So now I've got a caption. Not really that thrilled with it. So what can we do? Well, I can click on this and click center. I can click on this, click center. And then I can highlight this and tell it, let's say, make it bold, 10 pitch, calibri, which is something I use quite a bit. And now you've got a nice caption, but there's a gap, and I don't like the gap. Click on the picture once, come up here, tell it remove space after paragraph. Didn't do anything. Okay, then click the text, remove space before a paragraph. And you see now it's looking pretty good. I'm going to hit save. You'll learn to do that, and you'll probably see why later. Now, we've got one image in here. So let's scroll down and let's insert something in here someplace. This looks like a good spot. I'm going to hit insert, picture, and I want to put this picture here of the whole cable assembly. And you see it's huge. It fills up the whole screen, cuts the text in half, and that's not what I want to do. I want to show it off in line with the text. So come over to here to the width, set the width to about 4 inches, and you'll notice that the text starts here with the edge of the picture, but you've got a big gap here. So what I can do is, first off, click on this, click on Format Painter, and click on this, which will put the nice border around it. Then I can go to Format, and we have text wrapping. I'm going to tell it to wrap tight. What that does is it puts the text around the image. Now it doesn't line up just the way I want it, and so you can actually drag this down like that, and the text will float. It's a little bit of an art form. You gotta kind of get it the way you want it. Yay, there we go. Now, because the text is wrapping, you can see that putting a caption here might be problematic. So what do you do? Now this gets interesting. Right-click on it, tell it insert caption. And it says figure one, and we go cables. Alright? Or we'll tell it, you know, cable entry point. Notice I can't get rid of the figure one. This is the cable entry point. Okay? Here we got the text. It's the wrong color. It says figure one, and I don't want figure one and everything else. Well, at this point, you can actually go in and edit it. So I can backspace over this, get rid of the figure one. The funky blue text, well, we can take this text that we had up here, use the Format Painter, and paint over it. And you notice it corrected it. Looks great. So there we go. And if we take the picture and we move the picture around, oh gee, that does not move with it. So what you have to actually do is click on this, and you'll have to drag it down to where you want it, and you'll have to fiddle with it. It's just part of Word. Get used to it. Alright, so you've got that one in there, you're happy with it, looks great. Come down here, and let's say we want to put another one in here. Insert picture. This time we'll put the tower base in. Alright. Notice again, it's dropped it down here. It's all kind of funky and whatever. Hit Format Painter. Drop our format in there. Come over to text wrapping. And let's say we go tight again. Oh, where did the picture go? Well, Word decided that it should go up here on top of the other one. Why? I don't know. Grab it, drag it down where you think you want it, and there it is. And you see here, it's kind of too big, so we come in here and we'll adjust it down to, let's say, 2.5 inches. And I like typing them in versus dragging them most of the time, because I like to have some control over it. But if you want them to be the same size, like this is 4 inches, I can click on this, type 4, and you see they're the same size. Again, it's hanging down there too low, so we try sliding it up a little bit. Sometimes it'll work, sometimes it'll jump, and you'll end up having to play with the thing. And that's why I save often, because sometimes it really becomes an art form to get these things right. And you don't have to have the images on one side like this too. You can actually move the images around, try to, you know, make it a little bit more dynamic, a little more interesting, if you so choose. You can get interesting with it. Just be careful. You know, insert your caption. I usually just click OK and then type it in later. Come up here, get the format, drop the format in, ta-da, there you go. So, we have a nice pretty report, looks good, and what do? We save our work.
One other thing I want to cover on here rather quickly for you. These images could be quite large. This image could be 2 or 3 times the width of the paper here. Same thing goes for the images like this. Now, they're small in here, but the actual image itself could be much larger, 4, 5, 10 times larger. So what you can do is you can come and click on it, click on Format, and up here it says Compress Pictures. And what that will do is compress the picture down to a size that is just big enough the way you have it put into the document, so that it doesn't take up as much disk space. So we click on Compress Pictures, and it's asking if I want to apply it only to this picture or all pictures. Don't click anything, tell it OK, and now all the pictures in the document will be rescaled. Then go ahead and save, and your image size can go down from several megabytes down to less than 1 megabyte. And that's very handy for if you need to email your document to somebody.
Now that we've got images in our report, the report's looking pretty good. Let's say that we wanted to point out to somebody that having one of these grounding bars is important. One of the things that you could do is you can come up to Insert and insert a shape. These arrows are very useful. You can come over here and click an arrow like this. Then you can come over to the fill and you could pick a color like that. You can change the outline to a different color. You can change the thickness of the outline. Additionally, you can right-click on it and tell it Add Text. So you can put some text in there like that. Then what you can do is you can manipulate the size of this so that the text works and it looks really nice. You can also highlight the text and do things with it, like click bold, right justify it, center it, etc., until it looks the way you want it to look. And then once you get it right, you can move it around and so forth. Other things you can do is, let's say I wanted to show that these cables were tangled up and I wanted to make some comment about that. I could click on shapes, click an oval, and then I could drag this oval like this around it, come up to fill, and in this case tell it no fill. Come up and pick a color that stands out nicely, and then set the weight of the line to something that's going to stand out. Now, if I want to, I can grab this little green piece here and I can tilt it to kind of make it align with the image a little bit more. And so now we have a document, and it's got our images on there, nice and big, that span the entire document, images that are centered, images that flow with the text, either right or left justified. We have comments in them. We have captions underneath of them, and you have a completed document. So I hope this has been helpful. There's other things you can do, like headers and footers and so forth, but that's beyond the scope of this document. So hopefully this has helped you. Hopefully you've learned something. Have a great day.